Hello YouTube. In this video I want to show you how I make a buckler out of these two sheet metal pieces. They got cut out by a laser. I had a friend of mine cut them out for me. What you need is a welder, an anvil would be helpful, but a vise is also useful too, a hammer, a TIG welder would be good, or if you want to make it out of steel, I make it out of stainless steel. If you want to make it out of normal steel, you could take a MIG welder too, or MMA welding. To start with, we're gonna take this piece and start bending it with the thumb, fingers, just start bending it a little bit. And try to bend them all the same, about 10 millimeters, just for the first little bend. Then what I do is I pin them in here with a little hammer. Okay, now we go to the anvil. Try to take this round shape, get it round out. Top part of the bowl, get it rounded a bit. Okay. Now we shape the piece, put it in the anvil, just like that. Now take a pin hammer, 2-pound pin hammer, and start pinning it here. And as you see, it's almost perfect. Got it real nice. Now I could start and weld the ends together. Take them, get them perfectly and weld them together. And then, just here 1 centimeter, or about 1/2 inch. And then hammer the rest together perfectly. Well, that's it for the first welding. Now I'm gonna get a cool off and back to the anvil. This hammer, smooth surface. Well, all corners welded. Now we're gonna take off the oversized material. That's the belt sander. Take the angle grinder with a rough stone disc so I can get perfectly inside here and grind out these knobs. Ugly knobs. Flat disc, we do the fine work a little bit, take away the rough surfaces. Thank you. gonna grind off the corners at the right angle to the surface here. I want it to stand out just tiny bit so I have more material for welding. It melts down and welds in perfectly. Yeah. One small point, which is not that beautiful, but the rest is extremely beautiful, very well all around. Pretty happy with the result. It's not very true, but that's not a problem because we're gonna bend it anyway. And on the flat disc, we're gonna take off this one spot, which got not that beautiful. Now, gonna take off the colors. Removing the color, gonna take a special wheel. You can also do this with hand sanding or whatever you want. Good. sanding pad like this to get the colors away. Also, as you can see, start to disappear. It's just a very thin, very very thin layer of coloration. Yeah. Nice and shiny. We have to round off all the edges. We could have done it before welding or after welding, not a problem, but for sparring, for safe sparring, we need very round corners here, completely rounded. And as always, hand finishing needed to be done. Take 240 grit sandpaper. V shape, and this we're gonna make the notches. This is the rolling hammer. Start out at the tip. You see, it's pretty nice groove here, which ridges, which makes the shield or the buckler much, much stronger. Yeah. I repeat that to all 8 corners. Starts to look pretty awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Now, not like a normal buckler downside, we make it upside like a Talhofer buckler. For this almost last step before mounting the handle, I have an easy trick. My aluminum vice covers fit almost perfectly to my bends. And now I just need to push it down. Measure a bit how good it is. Just keep an eye on it. 20 millimeters, 19, 22, 35, and 30 millimeters. Okay, here we got 25, 22, 22. Thank you. Pretty nice. idea at the moment. Well, that's it. The buckler itself is finished. The discoloration or the colors you could move away, I'll let them like this. I like it.
But
buckler itself, I forgot to polish out. But my problem is the rough surface. Looks good. Looks nasty. So sorry guys, forgot to show you how I made the handle. See the little curve here and here, and it fits perfectly into the notch we made here before. And now drill the holes in the handle. Gonna mark it here. And then, not just marking it, we're gonna measure out the marks. If they fit exactly, 20 millimeters, 20 millimeters, perfect. Take a big drill to the bird holes here. Have a look. Now I'm gonna drill the holes into the wood and riveting all together and wrapping the leather around, mounting the handle, and the thing is finished. Corners both to the same level and the surfaces to the same level. Get it apart.
We need some big pliers.
A micro plier does it too. It's pretty powerful. Yep. Well, separated the handle. Now be careful. Should have been this way. Yep, see the markings? Correct. Cut off the rest of the rivets. And now now we're gonna rivet the whole thing together.
So I push it together while riveting. This handle is pretty sturdy. Maybe I don't need a ladder rack in any case, but we will see. Well, folks, that's it. Already mounted it. Pushed in the screw here and here. And that's it for today. Hope you liked it. Please give me a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this. And if you have any requests, just send me a comment or leave me a comment below. Thanks for watching.